गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आयन एक्सचेंज टेक्निक। आयन एक्सचेंज मे बी डिफाइंड एज रिवर्सिबल एक्सचेंज ऑफ आयन्स बिटवीन सॉलिड फेज एंड लिक्विड फेज इन विच देयर इज नो परमानेंट चेंज इन द स्ट्रक्चर। इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट। दिस टेक्निक इज कॉल्ड एज आयन एक्सचेंज। नाउ वॉट इज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ आयन एक्सचेंज? Ion exchange technique is carried out using special material called as ion exchange resin or ion exchanger. These resin are insoluble organic polymers onto which charge groups are introduced. The base of polymer is generally styrene divinyl benzene copolymer. The resin contains some ionic site where exchange of ions can take place. These sites may be cationic or anionic. When ions in the solution come in contact with these ions, they displaces this ion from their position and the solution coming out of the column contains ion of the resin. After complete separation of ions on the resin, one of the ion is eluted out with the help of suitable solvent. Other ions remains intact on the resin. Changing the solvent one by one, each ion in the mixture can be eluted out selectively. Now we are going to see types of ion exchange resin. Ion exchange resin are the insoluble organic polymer with a charge group attached at suitable position. The charge groups determine the types of resin. Ion exchange resins are of two types. So first is cation exchanger. Cation exchanger is high molecular weight cross-linked polymers having sulfonic, carboxylic, phenolic, etc. groups as a main group. An equivalent number of cations are attached to them. These cations are active ions and can be exchanged with cations in the solution. Generally, they are used in H plus or Na plus form. So, for cation exchanger in H plus form, the ion exchange equilibrium can be shown as follow. So, just see here. This is HNR, it is basically your cation exchanger resin, and NNA plus, so it is simply your sodium ion present in the solution. When this solution comes in contact with your cation exchanger resin, so basically this hydrogen goes in a solution as a H plus and sodium is attached to your resin. So here we see that Na and R plus your H plus comes in your solution and Na joined on your resin. For cation exchanger in sodium form, the ion exchange equilibrium can be shown as follow. So just see that this resin, it is a sodium form of a resin. So it contains sodium ion attached to your polymer. When it is come in contact with the solution having calcium 2 plus ion, so basically your sodium ion get replaces and calcium ion joins here and Na ions comes in the solution. So just see here, your resin attach with your calcium ion and Na plus ion goes in the solution. Cation exchanger may be further classified into strongly acidic and weakly acidic exchanger. In strongly acid cation exchanger like cross-linked polystyrene sulfonic acid, the ion exchange capacity is independent of your pH. However, in case of weakly acidic cation exchanger like those containing carboxylic COH group, basic condition have to be adjusted so as to enhance ion exchange capacity. Second type of exchanger is anion exchanger. Anion exchangers are polymer having amine or quaternary ammonium groups as an integral part of resin. An equivalent number of anions like chloride, sulfate, hydroxyl, etc. are attached to them. These anions can be exchanged with anions of solution as follows. So just see here, this is the example of anion exchanger resin because it contains a chlorine and we know that chlorine have negative charge. So it is example of anion exchanger resin. When it is come with the contact with the solution, so basically your this hydroxyl group get attached to the resin and chlorine ion comes into the solution like this. They can also be classified into strongly basic and weakly basic exchanger. Strong basic resin containing quaternary ammonium groups acts independent of pH, while activity of weakly basic resin is high in acidic condition. Now we are going to see ion exchange capacity. The total ion exchange capacity of a resin is dependent upon the total number of ion active groups per unit weight of material. Greater is the number of active groups, greater is the ion exchange capacity. Ion exchange capacity is defined as the number of millimoles of exchangeable group per gram of exchanger. For acidic resin, it is determined in a laboratory by measuring the number of milligrams of moles of sodium ions absorbed by 1 gram of dry resin in hydrogen form. For basic resin, it is determined by measuring the number of milligram of moles of chloride ions absorbed by 1 gram of dry resin in hydroxide form. In our next class, we are going to see determination of ion exchange capacity. Thank you very much.